strengthen the glutes and the hamstrings. We could do it our normal way, but I'm going to make a little change today. We're going to do a few little changes. Bring your left foot closer and move your right foot further away. Not dramatically, but you're just now you're off, your feet are slightly off. This will force the work into one leg more than the other. All right, so lift your chest, you're in the back bend. Inhale, lift your hips a little or a lot. If you feel strain in the left knee because you moved your foot too close, come down and just slightly shift your left foot forward, and then you may need to slightly shift your right foot forward. You don't want to feel strain in the knee. Here we go. Inhale, lift hips a little or a lot. You reach your thighs forward as you lift. Exhale, lower. That's simple. Now, if you're pretty strong, you won't feel this dramatically, but you probably, I'm guessing, feel like the left leg is getting a little bit more action than the right leg. That's why we do it off kilter, just to load one leg slightly. And because it's both feet down still, this is a great way into loading the leg. It's a little easier. Hold the pose now. Level your hips. Now in PT, they might have you do 30 reps and two sets of 30 reps. So quite a bit of bridges. So you can do a lot. Now we have the first setup. That's doable by almost everybody. The second setup, you can stay with the first setup. The second setup would be to reach your right leg to the sky. Keep a little bend in your right knee because we haven't really stretched this out yet. And then we lift and lower again. Lift. Now it's going to be a bigger load in the left leg. Good. One more. And then whichever one you're doing, we're going to hold. Breath in and breath out. Lower down. Now, because we're doing one-legged variations, we're not going to do as many as if I had both feet down. So one more round, a little different. Either the right foot stays forward as it has been, right leg to the sky as it has been, or cross your right ankle above your left knee. Lift, lower. Lift, lower. Lift, lower. Three, two, and then we hold. Deep breath in, full breath out. Keep your neck relaxed. Notice if your neck is and shoulders are jumping in. And then lower completely. Bring your right foot down. Hug your left knee into your chest. Slowly circle your left ankle. Good. Go the other way. Great. Awesome, everyone. Take your left leg to the sky. So hold your left leg as straight as it can be. You can relax your right leg down. That can be actually a little aggressive on the lower back. So keeping the right knee bent, a little safer for the lower back. And we're just stretching out the leg that we worked. Exhale, pull your foot back, spread your toes. Inhale, roll through your foot, point your toes. And now we're activating the foot. So as I pull back and point through, I'm also starting to get the arches of the foot more involved. Now they were involved in the stability that we created doing bridge pose like that. So you work the arches, you work the hamstrings, you work the glutes, and now we're stretching those muscles out. Flex your foot, lengthen through your inner knee all the way up to your big toe. You can use your hands lightly to draw your leg towards yourself, but keep the shoulders, neck soft. And we'll take about 8 full breaths here. All right, same leg, cross the left ankle above your right knee, and then draw your right leg in for eye of the needle pose. This probably gets a little more into the outer hip and the buttock area. So this is another part of your body that tightness or underuse could cause some irritation in the lower back, could also be somewhere else, but stretching the glutes can be helpful. Notice if you're using too much of your arms to keep your leg in, you want to keep the elbows soft, the hands soft, and you may need to just kind of pull your right outer hip down slightly so that you're not falling too much. Yep, exactly right, to the left. Now, actually, you've heard to flex your right foot a lot. Just let your right foot totally relax here. That's the one that's not crossed. That's it. One more breath. And release. All right, second side. Slide your right foot closer to you, slide your left foot further away. Lift your chest so that you're already in a back bend. Inhale, lift your hips a little or a lot, reach your legs forward. If you feel any strain in your right knee, come back down and just shift everything a little bit further forward. So walk the right foot forward, but also walk the left foot forward. So start with 2 feet down, one leg in front of the other, and lower down, nice and slow. Lift as high as you like, reach your legs forward. Stop if you feel low back pain, just don't come up so high. Point of this is not so much to arch the spine here, although that's happening, but is to work the hamstring and the glutes and the calves and the sole of your foot, that whole kinetic chain that will influence your hip, your knee, your ankle, your foot, and your lower back. Hold it up, breath in. And I can already tell for me that my right leg is stronger than my left leg. My left leg was feeling it come down already, just from this first one. Keep your feet as they are or reach your left leg to the sky. A little bend in the left knee, although we stretched it out already. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower, slow, easy, lift up and lower down. Inhale, lift up. Shoulders are relaxed. If you're pressing your hands down, that's cool. Just make sure that you're not aggressively pressing the hands down so that your shoulders are getting tense. That's why I like to work palms up here. Makes it a little more challenging, but I can notice when I'm getting too tense. Hold up, one breath. Come on down. Keep the first, second position or cross left ankle above right knee. Last round for bridges. Here we go, inhale, lift up. Exhale, lower down. Now in this variation, you want both the left and the right hip to come up at the same rate of speed. So you don't want to drop the left hip down and lift the right hip up. Same level. You got it. Three, two, hold it up. One breath in and out. Lower everything down. Draw your right knee into your chest. Eye of the needle, stretching. Oh, we did it. We're doing it in the reverse. That's cool. We were right here. Eye of the needle, stretching here. We'll do it two times on the right side. I promise you, it'll actually feel nice. Release. Okay, cross your right ankle above your left knee. Come back to eye of the needle. So we're gonna do it two times. We're just doing it slightly different sequentially than we did on the left. Relax your left foot. And I can already feel that I'm letting go a little more deeply in this than I sometimes do because we spent so much time working it. Now bring your left leg down, left foot down. Now take your right leg to the sky. circle your ankle the other way. Now go for it, extend your legs straight. You may or may not bring the left leg down. I'm gonna say for most of us, not. Just keep the knee bent. Extend from the inside of your right knee all the way up to the big toe, and then start to move the foot. Point and flex. So now we're getting into the ankle and the sole of the foot. You might even feel a little more calf work as you move the foot. Relax your shoulders, relax your neck. Great. Hold the flexed foot. Make your leg longer. Use your hands to pull the leg towards you, but relax your elbows in. So the hamstring attaches at your ischial tuberosity. That's your sitting bone. And then it comes all the way down. The three hamstrings, they cross behind your knee into your calf. So if you don't add the calf part in, you tend to load the upper hamstring. And that's why sometimes yogis get that pain around their butt. You want the stretch to go all the way into your calf. Now recross your right ankle again. Exhale back to eye of the needle pose. One more time here. Shoulders are relaxed. And come down. Give yourself a rest. Bring the feet wide, knees together. Let the lower back settle.